Hello, my friends. Today, we're answering a question that came in from one of our Learn Power BI family members, Venkatesh. And this is what Venkatesh is asking. And I'll show you exactly what he's talking about. So he has a dashboard with slicers filtering on due date fields, right? But regardless of what the filters are set to, there are he has some data which has for the start date and end date, it's blank. So the date values are blank. And he always wants to include that in the filters, no matter what the filter selection is, all right? So let me show you. So the closest I could get to that scenario in AdventureWorks was that I just use a single date, order date. And now in this case, we do have order date. I'm going to show you the data set where I hacked together in the query editor and I made it blank for some set of dates. So you can see here, this is the order date and it's blank for records which add up to $1.9 million. And it's there every time. Now, so if I understood Venkatesh correctly, what he wants is, doesn't matter what the selection in the date table is, the blank should always be shown. So in effect, imagine if the user selected 2016 and they also selected blank. So the blank should always be included and it should be reflected in the data that he's showing elsewhere. So again, this table is just there for debug purposes. I don't think that's what's being shown on his report. I'm gonna make that assumption. So he's showing some other information. And in this case, I picked like just sales by category and sales by occupation. But in both of these numbers, even when they select just 2016, we want to include the blank one as well. And you can see the including blank 2016 plus blank is 16.4 million. And that's what's being reflected over here. But again, we don't want the user to do this clumsy thing of select this and then hold down control key and select blank, right? So we want to make it easy for them and you just say, yep, you know, it doesn't matter what you select, we're always going to include and show blank. And I'm sure Venkatesh has a valid scenario for that. So let's zero in on this 2016 and we're going to see if we can create something so that as even though the user selects 2016, the blank is always included and we get this total 16.473 without them having to actually click the blank button. So I'm gonna duplicate that page and let's call it page two, why not? And here, I'm gonna unselect blank. Oops, let's just select 2016, but the total we're going for is that 16, I've forgotten it already, 16.473. So I'm gonna come in here and I'm gonna remove this year, month, and I don't need any of these actually. So let's just keep the sales number. All right, so we're on page two. This is where I want it to be working. And I want something that returns me always including the blank. So let's go ahead and write a measure and we can probably try to do it step by step. So let's just say new measure. And we're going to go over here and we'll say, I want to create sales, always include blank dates. And we're going to call WIP work in progress, you know, because we're still working on it. So I'm going to say, I want to calculate, let's just first see if we can calculate sales just for the blank date. So we'll say calculate sales. And this one is simple. I'll just say calendar date. Equals blank. All right, so let's see. Well, this is actually, you know what? I'll just say, for now, I'll just say blank dates. So this is what it's showing right now. And I'm gonna add that here. And notice here that it does what it says, it always shows the blank date total. So no matter what is selected, we just get the blank date total, right? So it's always kind of including that. So let's, I think we can use two approaches from here. Let's try both. All right, so I had a fancy approach in mind. In fact, that's the first one that I tried, but then I realized that there's a simple approach as well. So I'll walk you through the same process. So let's do the fancy one first. That, oddly enough, that came to me First, that's the first one that I thought of. So I realized that I can do this, and I can say, show me the sales for where the calendar is blank. And that's the filter context that I'm creating, and filter context. And when I specify it this way, it overrides any incoming filter context. If you want to learn more about DAX and filter context, I do have a playlist, and I'm going to link it in the description or somewhere on this video. So I wanted to create the context, which is a combination of whatever is being passed to me in the filter over here and the blank dates, right? So when I thought about that, it felt like I need a union. So that's the way I went first. So I'm gonna grab this this measure and create a new measure. And we're gonna say sales, and we'll say always include blank dates. I'm hoping we can get it right, so I'll remove this one. So I'll say calculate sales, and then I wanted to do a union of this with the essentially the calendar table that's coming in. And hold on, I'll write it out kind of step by step. So now, of course, this doesn't like me doing this calendar date equals blank, because union expects a table. So how do we build a table which has the blank one? And maybe there's an easier way to do that, but I use this filter calendar and calendar date equals blank. Now this, if you leave it this way, is actually not going to work, because we do need to clear the incoming filter context as well. So we're going to say all calendar, because the incoming filter context doesn't have the blank dates, right? The incoming filter context just has 2016 in there. So we're going to say all calendar, and then zero in just to the calendar date blank, and union that with the calendar table. And now I think we're just missing a bracket. And let's see. Hold on. Let me see what's going on with that squiggly thing. All right. Didn't have my brackets right. So I think that's sorted out. So let's see how this works in action. So we have now this new column. Let's see if it shows me that 16.5. It does, 16.473. So it's giving me the right number. And now I can use that instead of this sales measure in here. So I can go and I say always include the sales one, and do the same thing over here. Remove that one and add this new measure. And it's always going to include the blank values, and we're gonna test that in action as well. So here we have the number, and so we can see 2016. We only selected 2016. We don't have to go select 2016 and blank, but it's including the. And again, this is just a working pivot, as I call it. So we wouldn't really show it. So, but as you can see, these graphs and tables, whatever we're showing, they always include the blank dates. Let's just test one other out. So what happened if we selected 2015 and blank? So again, in our basic measure, the number we're looking for is 7.711. So now if you go here, again, all we're going to do is just select 2015, and you can see that the number is 7.711. So that's working. So that was the fancy approach. But as I was recording this video, I realized that maybe there's a really, really simple approach. Let me reduce the size a little bit so we can fit that and show you that as well. So great. So this is one. And the other approach that I believe you can use is, I'm going to remove the fancy measure that we built. And so I love building things in building blocks. So I looked at this and I realized that, oops, we have both building blocks. What if we can just do A plus B? And I think it does work. It's possible that there's some scenarios that would break down. I couldn't quite process it in my head right away, but let's just try that. So let's just try the simpler approach, and we'll say sales always include blank dates, and we'll call this V2, and this would simply be like this plus this. So we'll say give me sales and plus the sales with the blank dates. So right, so it's doing the blank dates, and I'm going to take the WIP off of that other measure, because I don't think that's a work in progress anymore. All right, so let's try out our new measure, V2, and see how that does. So I'm going to put V2 over here, and you can see that it it has the same result. I'm going to pause the video and just see if it works the same way on these graphs and tables. I would believe it would. All right, so I cleaned it up, and now we have the V1 of the solution, and you can see you can select 2015, 7.7, it includes the blank, 2016, 16.473, it includes the blank, and we have the solution V2, which was a simpler approach, and it has the same, it shows the same numbers as well. Now, of course, I'm going to up the challenge a little bit, so I operated on an assumption, and that's what data modeling is about. You get to crossroads, and there are decision points, and there are assumptions you make. So one big assumption that I made in this process was that the graphs being shown do not actually involve the date field. Now this is crucial because if you did want to show something like this, did want to show the dates and show up that the blank dates, then I believe you cannot solve it using this measure approach because the slicer filters out the blank dates, so you're not able to display it in that visual regardless of how you calculate the measure. Go ahead and give it a try and let me know what you find there. All right, until next time, power on, my friend. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.